a beautiful Snow TV. Welcome back, Snowflakes, and welcome if you are new. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell notifications so you don't miss another time when I upload. So we're gonna go ahead and use these simple products today. I know this video is kind of late. I recorded this almost 2 weeks ago, guys. Y'all, a lot has happened in that time frame. So it's very simple. As you see the products, I'm just gonna be using some gel polish from Rosalind, and I'll be using some Evie's patty gel. Y'all, I use almost all that patty gel. I have my tips on with my peel off base, and we're gonna be using 91% alcohol this time. I usually grab whatever alcohol I get from the grocery store or the dollar store, you know, whatever's available at that point. If it's 70%, I grab like 4 at a time because I use it quite a bit. But this is what we're gonna be using for today. I don't know if you guys can hear, but my voice is not at 100%. I was sick over this past weekend, and before that my mom was sick, so it was a lot going on, and I just was not able to put all my time and focus into my videos. I do apologize, but I have more content coming. If you guys follow me on Instagram, make sure y'all follow me on the gram and follow me on TikTok. Your girl is back on TikTok. So I am going to be trying to upload videos there on the regular as well. But we're going to go ahead and get into this polygel application. So this is a simple polygel application. Just going to be doing all the nails this nude color as a base. And then once we're done with that, we're going to go ahead and cure. As you guys know, you're going to see me do this with my wooden cuticle pusher. If you don't know, now you know. Make sure you guys go grab you a pack. They're like $4 on Amazon. So with this just helps with application. As you can see, it's clearly building the apex a little bit better than a brush would. A brush, it's more for smoothing for me now. Now that I've come into this tip and trick, it's more for smoothing. As you can see, it gives a beautiful apex. Look at that. It just smooths out all the imperfections. I did take a little bit longer because I was really trying to be kind of scarce with the polygel because I didn't want to run out of this color because I do need another color. But now that application is all done, I'm gonna go ahead and I've already wiped the nails off with alcohol. I'm just gonna go in with my e-file here. This is a 100 grit sanding band, coarse sanding band. I do go over all the nails with the sanding band first and under the nails as well, just to kind of go over you know, a general area, making sure it's all smooth and everything like that. But I still do use my hand file. I do trust my hand file. So I'm just gonna go ahead and switch out my little bit here. I'm just gonna go in. I want to try this little flat bit that I got from AliExpress, and I don't know, I felt like maybe I didn't think this was gonna be this small, so I feel like it's because of the size that it did not, you know, really impress and really do any good, you know, deed for me. That was just, this is my perspective. Now maybe on your natural nail or something like that, but on extendos or nail extensions period, I don't feel like this would be, you know, beneficial. I feel like it's a waste of time. Or even if you want to try to use it for like shaping up the sides, as you see guys, I put that down very quickly, and I'm just gonna go in with my hand file, my trusted process here. I'm just gonna go in and file as normal. I even tried to pick it up again, but it just wasn't getting it as straight for me as I wanted it. Like in the middle, it wobbled on the surface, so I wasn't feeling that. So I did go in with my hand file after I tried to do a different method here, but you know, it is what it is. You know, we tried different things and that's how we learn. So I did go ahead with my hand file and finish it off, and then I did the rest of the nails off camera as well. But make sure you guys follow me on Instagram and TikTok. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, y'all. We're trying to get to 600. Every 500 subscribers there will be a giveaway, and my giveaway winner never came forward. I am wondering where you were. Did you fall off the face of the earth, girl? Come forward and grab this stuff. Keep on, I'm gonna use it myself because it's some good product. So make sure you come forward and get your products. So back to the video. So I'm just gonna go ahead and finish filing. I am so sorry about my voice, guys. Y'all have to excuse me, but yeah, I'm just gonna let you guys finish watching this process. Thank you. And voila, the nails are all file shaped and buff. These are so, so beautiful, guys. We're gonna dust them off and get right to the nail art. And this is how the nails are looking after I did go ahead and spray them with some alcohol. It looks so, so cute and clean. Honestly, you can wear them like this with some stones and top coat it and go, but we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit of nail art. This is gonna be some simple abstract croc print. Now, disclaimer, I thought I had clear acrylic. I usually don't use acrylic on my channel besides for, you know, texture purposes. I thought I had clear acrylic, but I did not. It was white acrylic, guys. I was so upset, and I was literally halfway through the nail set, and I said, well, let me try it first just to kind of, you know, see what it'll look like. Y'all, it was so ugly. I was not pleased with that white acrylic that, you know, was trying to work its way into my nail set. So I did go ahead and file that off of my thumb, and then I just you know, went in with top coat. I thought I wanted to leave it. Now, what I should have done, I'm just gonna go ahead and do like some simple abstract art here on the ring finger. And what I did was I was gonna do like some Frenchies and just do like a little abstract art, and on the abstract art, go ahead and do like the croc print for the brown part. But what I should have done, I should have matted the base of the brown, like this base right here that I'm drawing. I should have matted this part and then went ahead and drew my abstract art right here, and then I should have placed my gel on top in the form of my croc print, if you get what I'm saying. That's usually how it's done, depending on what kind of style you're going for, what kind of look you're going for, but that's usually how it's done. So that's what I should have done, but my brain was on, you know, I don't know what time of night it was at this point, so I did not do that. But I still feel like the nails came out okay. You know, I feel like they came out cute. If it wasn't cute, I wouldn't have posted it, wouldn't have finished video recording. So I hope you guys like the set. So what I did on the ring finger, I'm just gonna go ahead and do on the thumb as well, and just kind of, you know, let you guys let the play out from here. So I'm just taking some brown, beautiful chocolate brown color from Rosalind, And I'm just going to go in with that and just create these little swirls here throughout the nail on the, tip of the nail, and then go ahead and color it in. And then I'll come back with the Croc print art, and then I'll go ahead and cure for a full 60 seconds when you do that. And then I'll go ahead and put my stones, and then we'll top coat and we'll be all finished. This is somewhat of a shorter video for me. It's only like, a few minutes here, but I did want to show the whole process of me doing the whole set, especially the art and the bling. But that's pretty much what I'll be doing for the rest of the set. I'll pop in and out and make sure you guys are, just explain what I'm doing throughout the video. I don't even know what to say anymore, guys. Like, I'm so flustered. But I'm just gonna go ahead and cure that for 60 seconds right there. Alright guys, as you can see, this is not sped up. This is how slow I work. So, excuse the background noise if you do hear that motorcycle. Like, what are they doing that for? I know you're trying to have fun out here, but I'm trying to record a video. But I am doing this in real time. I did not speed this up for you guys. This is how slow I work, guys. This is also why I don't have many clients, because I'm not aspiring to be a nail technician. I'm just not. That's never been my ambition. I really enjoy doing my own nails. This is like a therapy for me. If I've had a bad day at work or just having a bad day, period, I come and, come to my desk and I really just do nails. Like, I will sit here for hours and really recenter myself with a beautiful design, or just, playing around or swatching, just anything related to nails. Majority of the time it's actually doing my nails. So this is a therapy of mine. I don't really need or prefer to have clients, but this is what, I do when I'm, need to get in a good space or in a good place in my own mind. And this is a therapy for me. But this is in real time. This is how I do my French tips. I will have more how-to videos coming up. They're going to be, broken down into different videos. I've seen another YouTuber do that. I was like, man, that saves a lot of time. So as you see here, I did kind of speed it up. As you can see, I did like the A method, or what they call an AT method. I don't know if you call it a T method or A method. I'm combining them and I call it an AT method, like an at method. So that's how I got my perfect French right there. Like, that was beautiful. Like, it was so pretty. And surprisingly, me drawing it upside down was like so much better. Like, I have no idea why that was. I'm starting to do that more. I'm not sure why that is either, but I'm just gonna go in and with my long liner brush there, I'm just gonna go ahead and fill the rest of the French in, and then we'll come back with the next step. And if you did not notice, you're more than halfway through this video, so make sure you guys click on that subscribe button and support your girl for free. Yes, I'm gonna say it every video. Thank you. So here's where I was telling you guys earlier in the video where I should have just matted the rest of the nails and like then did the gel polish croc on top. Because once I top coat this, it's gonna get lost in the top coat, but it'll still be noticeable to a certain extent. Or I could have matched the base poly gel with the croc print and did like a lighter brown. Wasn't thinking, but still a cute set. Still a cute set. I really love the concept of the set. I've been wanting to do some brown for a while because I've had this brown set. I hope you guys like this thumb. I'm loving this thumb and the abstract with it. It's so cute. But yeah, let you guys watch this, and I'm gonna go ahead and cure that for 60 seconds, and I'm gonna do the same thing on this one as well. I'm just gonna let you guys watch the rest of this play out. So here I thought I was going to be cool and try to use this more advanced top coat. First of all, it was coming out that bottle brown, and I didn't know if I liked that. Like, it wasn't given. And so, as I was putting the top coat on, as you can see, my design is getting so lost. But, you know, it is what it is. like I said, the design was still cute. I just tried to, you know, not put as much top coat on there to try to, you know, make the croc print pop, but so I just, you know, went ahead and top coated, and I pulled out my Beatles top coat because that wasn't given. I think I did wipe that off, but I did go ahead, look at that, shinier, smoother, like y'all, better, all that. You would think I'm talking about Papa John's pizza, but I am just gonna go ahead and put my rhinestones on, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and cure for a full 60 seconds with each nail. So isn't that little stone cute? I thought silver would be really cute with these nails. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and cure that. So I'm gonna go ahead and start on the other nails with the rhinestone placement. I did kind of freestyle on some of them, but you guys are gonna watch that, and then I'll come back in with some final results. Thank you. And I'm just going to go in with the final rhinestones here, and then I'll go ahead and cure for a full 60 seconds for the whole nail set, and then we'll be back with the final results. Alright, and here is how the nails came out. They are so, so cute. I'm loving this brown on my brown. I am loving that color. I love a good, nice nude. Like, this was really, really cute. So we're going to go ahead and take some cuticle oil, and we're going to go ahead and nourish our cuticles because they dry AF. And then we're also going to go ahead and get those final shots, guys. So once again, thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much for clicking on this. Thank you for your support. And we can only go up from here, Snowflakes. I am loving the support, the community that we have built. I am appreciative of every single subscriber that even comments. Even if you just watch and don't say anything, I still appreciate you and you have my eternal gratitude. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.